Hello friends, today we'll discuss about the basic difference between the Jones and pseudo-Jones fracture. Myself, Dr. Kadir. Let's label this picture for better understanding. The lower one is the cuboid bone, the red marked bone is the fifth metatarsal and the bone beside is the fourth metatarsal. The most important region is the articulating surface between the fourth and the fifth metatarsal. The zone which corresponds to this articulating surface in the fifth metatarsal bone can be marked like this. Anything which is proximal to this marked zone should be called as zone 1. This marked zone which corresponds to the articulating surface is zone 2. And anything which is distal to this zone is zone 3. A fracture can either happen in zone 1 or at zone 2 or at zone 3. If the fracture is happening at zone 1, that is what called as pseudo-Jones fracture. And this is the most common fifth metatarsal fracture. And you should also know this is usually due to peroneus brevis avulsion or plantar ligament avulsion. Very, very common in athletes, military recruits and dancers. And since it has its own good vascularity, usually non-union is uncommon. If the fracture happens at zone 2, that is what called as the typical Jones fracture. And remember, it is a vascular watershed area, so non-union is more possible. And if the fracture happens in zone 3, that is usually due to a stress fracture, and it is again very common in athletes and increased risk of non-union. That is the basic difference between Jones and pseudo-Jones. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe.